today I'm gonna make these chocolate chip oatmeal cookies here. I have the recipe. So this bowl is gonna be for the dry ingredients. It's gonna be for the wet ingredients. First, we'll need 2 sticks of butter. Take them out of the freezer, leave them until it gets to room temperature. I'm gonna peel this so I can get some extra butter. Okay, then take the second one. Okay, and then we'll take the paper towel so you can wipe your hands off. I'd be glad that you just leave it out for the eggs. Then you'll get 1 cup of brown sugar, this cup, and then pour it into any kind of brown sugar. You gotta open that up. So it's like that. You can pour that in. Okay. And I'll take the sugar and then put one fourth here, this cup. And that's all you need for that. Then after you do that, I'm gonna go to the mixer. This kind of mixer here, and then just put it like that. Let's secure it. I'm gonna bring this closer. I'm gonna pick this up, and then I'll first go to like stir, then go to 2, wait for a while. And then I guess we'll go to 4. No, 6. No, 4. Okay, we're gonna go back into the drying room. The dry ingredients. So next is 1 1/2 of oats. So I have these crackers here. Crackers would be so good. Here I'm gonna get 1 cup. I'm gonna get 2 cups of flour. So I'm gonna put the cap. also work for like for one of those spec things, mysteries. Yeah, I'm going to put the second cup out. Just like scrape the sides. Then just gonna other things I want to tell you about while we're scraping sides is that the first thing you need to do is wash your hands. So, in case you need to do a little taste test. I'm gonna try this. I think that tastes good. I'm gonna take. And just put that there. And let it keep going. Dry ingredients. Next is 1 teaspoon of baking soda. Once I made brownies, I put too much baking powder. But it still tastes good. Here's the baking powder. I told you I put too much. And the brownies, half a teaspoon of this. I like to do this to like measure it like like use this to like scrape off the sides like that. Next is 1 teaspoon of salt. So I'm gonna get this teaspoon. I have this piggy salt. Yeah. I'm gonna use this spoon to like do this to like the brush. I got some in here. I'm just gonna put some on here. Can't hurt. Okay, next is chocolate chips, which I will do later. I'm gonna go back to there. Get my cookie. Okay. I'm gonna get This is why you need you're gonna need that within your tunnel. I usually sometimes put it on 10 to go faster, then I stop. So it goes a little faster, gosh. Okay, there it goes. Okay, go easy. Okay, I'll make it stop, take the side, and do a little two step.
I'm gonna make that go a little higher. I'm gonna go here.
I would like grab a big spoon, something like this, and just mix this together. I'll wait for like a minute or two and then I'll take that out and then I'll show you what I'm doing. While I'm waiting, I'll just put my ingredients in there like just flip them. Cleaned up all my stuff. Okay, so I'm gonna go back over there. Stop this. Put this away. I'm gonna get this. First take this off. I do. Here. Then I would. I'm not gonna waste all that, so we're gonna. What? Like, yeah, I used to make these, and then there was, like, so much cookie dough that, like, it lasted almost a whole month. Okay, I'm gonna just save this in case you wanna make it. Oh yeah, you have to, I forgot, but you have to preheat the oven to 350. Start at what bake? See, because I usually bake cookies, so it always goes there. Okay, it's gonna start like that. Sometimes it does. Okay, so I'm gonna this one. Don't worry about that. I'm gonna get my spatula. And like, I would mix this for a while, like, take all this stuff in. And then I'm gonna dump this in. I'm gonna do a couple more. I'm just gonna do a few minutes of this. Well,
like a teensy bit. And then I'll pour the rest. I actually once like poured the butter in here. And I had to take everything out, like it was like the brown sugar and the sugar. And I just dumped it in here, so I had to clean the other bowl. It was supposed to be the dry stuff. Sometimes I do it on the ground, so like I hold it with my legs. And then I just like do it with two hands. It's much easier. I always do that.
Yeah.
I'm gonna do that right now. So you go like this. And then you just hold it like this. And you could just stir it with something like that. It's much easier. We're gonna have to do this again for chocolate chips. So, now I'm gonna... Where'd that go? Do I have to go back in there? Okay, so I found this. It was right next to me. You're gonna need, since there's a little chocolate, you're gonna need this, this. Just pour the whole, not the whole thing, but you know what I mean. Okay, I got this. I'm gonna pour it in. I'm gonna put this a little bit. So, the chocolate chips doesn't spill. I'm gonna mix them and do it on the floor. I'm gonna do it on the floor now. Like how I told you just do this and just mix. I'm gonna get this up here and just come down. Let's stick it. Okay, I knew that. That would happen. I was like, don't stick it. Don't make sure it doesn't stick on your hand. Well, just stick on my hand. Because that's what it always does. I'm going to spread that out. Okay, I'm going to just mix a little more. I'm going to get all that stuff down here. So this is the hard part. You got to, like... Put it all in the okay, so I finished this. I'm going to wrap it around. Make sure it gets in there. It's all fluffy, 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 fluffy. So like a bouncy. Just in case, I'm going to put another one around. Just going to get another one just in case. No, that's not yet. That's just in case. I, for some reason, it would stay overnight. I'm just gonna keep that. Okay. Just stay right here. Never mind. Yeah, it's at 350, so then it's supposed to be. Yes, okay, so so this is where it's supposed to be. You should get some things. And then I'll just show you what to do. Okay, so we're ready. It has been an hour, I think. I have this cookie dough pan and sheet ready. I'm gonna go cookie dough. Usually I leave it for like almost overnight or something, but this should be enough. Maybe we're gonna get a little messy for this one. So I'm gonna open my first one and then my second one. So I'm messy. Here, then you're gonna get like maybe this, something like that. And just like run a ball. So we're gonna make it into another ball. Your balls will kind of look like all like spread out like cat fur, like on a witch's broom. It'll look like that. It's still gonna be fun. Sorry about that. Oh. It would be cool if there were music, but
can I ask a question?
Yes.
How do you like to eat these cookies? Like for breakfast or for snack?
I don't usually eat them for snack, but a good time would be for snack. It's really good with milk. You dip it in, it's like amazing. If you freeze it more, it wouldn't be looking like all this like wet stuff. But that's how it's gonna look for now. They're gonna look like this,
But they're gonna look better when you cook, when you bake it.
And how many cookies do you usually make?
I think 11, because I usually do like 4, 3, 4. And then like once I was like making this, I had a little extra. So we used a pan, and then we used one of these tiny cookie dough sheets to use the rest. It was actually pretty cute. And then you could like smush it so it doesn't get all puffy. You can like smush it down a little, like smash it. Just a little, not too much. I think I'm gonna have to move this over here a little bit more. Right there. This should take a little bit more. Set a timer for 10 minutes.
Timer for how long?
10 minutes.
10 minutes. Starting now.
Very short.
Okay, so can I ask another question?
Sure.
What's next? What's next?
Usually not supposed to be that big. I never usually actually made them this big. Let them cool for like, let's say, 5-3 minutes. Okay, we're gonna go get some milk for the cookies. And pour them in the cup. Going to chat a cookie taste. I get Over here. Don't forget to subscribe.